Hey guys, Dillard here, back in with another review, and today we're doing something a little different. Today we're taking a look at the Disneytronics GVE Mickey Mouse versus Chernabog. Now, I'm going to go over this line and the movie that these two characters both come from briefly here. So, Disneytronics is a line that was released in, I believe, 2006 or 2007, somewhere around there. I didn't see them when I went down to Disney World, that is, back in 2007. So maybe they came out in 2006 and I just missed them by a month or something. I don't know. I don't recall seeing them, because I know if I saw this guy, I would have bought him, because he looks freaking metal. But that's besides the point. This line came out around that time. And it's basically the Disney heroes, quote-unquote, versus the villains. And everyone gets a mech suit. So it's kind of like Gundam, but with Disney characters. It's pretty cool. And it's kind of coincidental because we just did that Ghost Rider mech suit Transformer figure. that just popped into my head randomly. But, that's pretty much Disneytronics. It was this offshoot line. I think you could only get it in the parks, so they're kind of hard to find. They're not necessarily expensive, but, although I do think it's funny, they did come out around the same time as the original line of Haunted Mansion figures and the Pirates of the Caribbean figures I just took a look at a couple of weeks ago. Funny how that works. But moving on from that, Fantasia. That's the movie these two come from. And Fantasia, I'm going to say it, is probably one of my, if not my favorite Disney movie, just because of literally 20 minutes. It's amazing how that works. Fantasia came out around 1939, I believe. It was right before the 1940s. And it's basically a series of animated music videos for classical music. They took songs that were famous / infamous from the classical genre of music, and they pretty much made cartoons to go with them. Sorcerer's Apprentice featured Mickey Mouse, of course, who was a Sorcerer's Apprentice. To, I believe his name was, Yensid, which is actually Disney backwards. Yensid is the sorcerer, but the people who worked on the movie named him kind of after Walt Disney, so that's an interesting little tidbit there. But, Mickey makes a bunch of brooms and buckets of water and all kinds of cleaning supplies come to life, and they're walking down the stairs, doing all this crazy stuff. And then there was a crappy remake of it in like 2010. Yeah, there was a live action version of The Sorcerer's Apprentice featuring Nicolas Cage and the main character from How to Train Your Dragon, believe it or not. It wasn't terrible, but it's kind of unneeded, I'm just saying. And then there's Night on Bald Mountain, which is part of the end of the film, because it bleeds into Ave Maria, which is another highlight of the film, that and the scene with the dinosaurs. But Night on Bald Mountain is basically this. The devil awakens on Halloween night on Bald Mountain, brings back everybody from the dead, and they throw the most heavy metal Halloween party I've ever seen. There's like skeleton dudes on horses. There's like ring wraith looking dudes. There's demons, there's gargoyle-looking things, there's harpies with exposed breastises. I'm not kidding. It's pretty freaking wild, and I wouldn't imagine that a lot of kids peed their pants seeing that thing, because here's the deal. The kids were peeing their pants so bad during a scene in Snow White, they had to change the velvet seats. They probably had to change the seats altogether when they saw this guy on screen. So, yeah, that's a little history on Fantasia and Disneytronics in a line. Hopefully it won't be as long-winded in the future. reviews to come for these guys. So, moving old Chernabog, aka Mecha Satan, out of the way. Let's look at Sorcerer's Apprentice Mickey. And I gotta be honest with you, not my favorite. He's missing something, ain't he? Yeah, his ears. They're on there, but they're really small and insignificant. I've never seen a Mickey figure of any variety where he doesn't have his ears. There's a Mickey Transformer that even has his ears. What the hell is this? So, yeah, and he's hunched, and it's just... Some of these translate really well. Some of them, not so much. I would have to put this guy in the not-so-much category. He does have a cape, though. It does peg in via a little rectangular peg on the back. Well, on the cape that goes into his back. Which is a little tricky to get in there. Just because of how snug a fit it actually is. And then he also has this water bucket cannon. Which is, you know, supposed to be a nod to the movie. So, yeah. Pretty cool. But, yeah, look at it. His face is good. That's the thing. They got the face pretty good. It looks kind of like a mix of Mickey and Optimus Prime. But he doesn't have his freaking ears. And it just... ruins the aesthetic for me. But articulation on this guy's head rotates, but it's at a weird angle, so he kind of looks to the side, but he's kind of like... It's kind of like some exorcist crap. It's like... But, yeah. He's got a swivel in the shoulder, which is a little loose on mine in some areas, but is tight up here. That doesn't make any sense. Yeah, see, it's not even flopping down. Well, it did that time. It does also move out. And then he has a hinge in the elbow as well as a swivel. Swivel at the wrist. Swivel at the waist. Swivel at the hip. And a hinge at the knee that gives you almost 90 degrees. The hinge in the elbow gives you a little less than 90. So that's kind of unfortunate, but oh well. What are you going to do? But yeah, that's Sorcerer's Apprentice Mickey. Now for the star of the show. At least as far as I'm concerned, if I can get a hold of him. Chernabog. Now, funny story about this particular Chernabog, because I have had two of these before. I sent the other one to a buddy of mine. When I bought this one, he was listed as Chernaborg. I believe it was in a lot with him, Sorcerer's Apprentice Mickey. I think the Stitch 2-pack, if I'm not mistaken, which is kind of random, but oh well. But yeah, he was listed as Chernaborg, which is kind of cool. Kind of stupid, but kind of cool because, you know, cyborg, robots, Chernabog, kind of works. And I read something online about this figure that it's kind of a downgrade because Chernabog's like the size of a mountain. Not exactly. I don't think he was like, you know, 100 feet tall. That mountain he was on was ginormous, so I could be wrong. I don't know how big that mountain was, but it looked like the mountain was like the Empire State Building, and he was like the top 10% of it. Still big, but not like... freaking... If anything, this is more or less an armored version of Chernabog. He's not going to just be sitting in here. He's going to be like, this is a helmet, this is armor... throughout his body. His wings even got armor. I don't know. I just feel like this is a mech suit as opposed to a... or a suit of armor as opposed to a mech suit. Like in old Mickey's case. But looking at him, he's got the same... kind of... articulation as Mickey. Except his head joint works a lot better because it's a swivel in the neck. So he can actually look... side to side rather effectively, which is nice. I like that. Other than that, he's got these wings which peg into his back via these little tabs here. They are keyed. You can't rotate these. That would be kind of cool. You could rotate these because some of the tails do rotate, or you know, some of them have extra parts that move, but the ones with wings don't. And then he's got this little green flame here. Kind of looks like a booger. But it's a little green flame you just pick into his hand like that. And he's got the same articulation as Mickey, otherwise he's got the hinge in the shoulder, which he can move out all the way. Like, that's pretty rad. I can move forward and back, swivel at the elbow, hinge at the elbow, swivel at the wrist, swivel at the waist. And he even has, like, a little bit of a loincloth detail here. It kind of has that flame look from the mountain, as if he's sitting on the mountain still. And that's kind of neat. And then he also has a swivel in the leg and a hinge in the knee. You don't get a lot out of that. He does have some wiggle in the foot, but they don't pose, I don't think. It kind of looks like they do, but they don't. But, yeah. I forgot to mention with Sorcerer's Apprentice Mickey, mostly because it's a little bit more obvious on this guy. They do have little core pieces, kind of like arc reactors, if you're familiar with Iron Man. His is like a little mountain, if you can see that there. And I believe Mickey's is like a water bucket or like a broom or something. Not to give you a Mickey Mouse crotch shot or anything. Oh, no, it's a moon. He's got a moon. And old Chernabog's got a, it's got a mountain. So that's pretty cool. They kind of gave him a little bit of personality. I like that. But that's pretty much it. You know, they're cool little robot figures. There's not much to say other than that. Again, it's kind of like Gundam meets Disney, but it's not as stupid as you think it might have been. Let's get this back in focus here. Size comparison, do I really got to do one? I guess I will, because everyone cares about if anything scales with Marvel Legends, and I can tell you right now, these do not. they scale with each other in like 4-inch Gundam figures, probably. Other than that, nah. You know what? They probably scale well with the Transformers The Legends class figures. You know what? Hold on. I got one somewhere, don't I? Let me see here. Where is he? Oh, there he is. This is like Shockwave on steroids, but you'll just have to deal with it. There they are with Shockwave. And yeah, they're a little small for that too, but I guess that could work. I know they make some Transformers Legends smaller than that. What the heck is this even from? This Shockwave is from like the Cyberverse line, I think. I just had him sitting here, so I figured I'd do a quick comparison for you. Since I don't have a lot of 4-inch figures, because I'm pretty much a 6 to 7-inch scale, I dabble in the 8-inch. Watch it, comments. it's just that these are so cool, I had to have them. And I don't have a lot of Disney stuff. I have the Pirates of the Caribbean figures, the two I just looked at. I probably have some from the movie somewhere still. And I also got the infamous Mighty Ducks and some of the Disney Afternoon stuff. And then, of course, my Gargoyle shelf, my pride and joy. That is my Gargoyle shelf. So, you know, if you're a Disney fan, you'll probably dig these. If not, you know, you probably won't. So, it's up to you. I think Chernabog has a little bit more appeal just because he's a robot demon. And that's badass. But Mickey is very specific, and I don't think the aesthetic's as good as Chernabog here. So I'd say if you had to get one, get the Chernabog, but they were releasing 2-packs, so you probably got no choice. But with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Stay tuned. We're going to be taking a look at more of these as time progresses, not all at once. I said I was going to do that before, but I changed my mind. I do that often. Deal with it. But until next time, I will catch you guys later. Oh, I'm gonna kick your ass. Mecha Satan! I couldn't resist.